Hello to all our fans on QQ Music. This is Dan from Imagine Dragons, and I just want to say thank you for listening. Thank you for supporting us, and we can't wait to come to China soon. Know what you've been holding back, heart attacks every night. Oh, you know it's not right. I will follow you way down, wherever you may go. I'll follow you way down to your deepest low. I love that you asked that question. No one's asked me that yet. So the point of these two songs, and we're going to do this, the whole record is split into half. So it's one record, but it's really two-sided. There's half of it that's about looking out, and half of it that's about looking inward. And as we release songs, there'll be one from each side of the record, even though it's one record. But it just thematically in my head worked that way. And Cutthroat is about looking in. And it's kind of an exorcism of self-pity is kind of the way I've thought of it. And something about the aggressiveness of fire and fire of self. It's kind of like the refiner's fire, which is what the song is about, right? It's about killing a part of me that I really don't like, which is the part that is self-loathing. It's like, woe is me, because my life is actually incredible, and I'm very blessed, and I have very little things to complain about. So that's what the art is for on Cutthroat. And Follow You is a song about my wife and I, who have now been married for 10 years. We went through a separation of 7 months, which was a really difficult time period for both of us, but we ended up choosing to stay together. And had another child. And when we got back together and made it through that difficult time period of literally 7 months of no talking to each other. And it really came from just a lot of stress of tour and traveling the world for a long time and not being as present as I would have liked. But it's a song about that. And so I wanted that to be displayed in the image about loyalty, an image that really symbolizes that. So that's what the artwork for both of them symbolizes. Thanks for asking that. No one else has asked me that. You know, I think as I get older, the thing that's most important to me in life is just vulnerability and honesty. I value those traits in others most of all. When I'm with people, I want to have a vulnerable conversations. I want to know their truth. I want to know how they're feeling. I don't want to write music that's anything but that. I want to write music that makes you really feel something, that makes you think of something. And sometimes you have to go to places that are difficult, especially like on Follow You. I've never written a love song really before, maybe like once. Other in our career, I don't, because it's very vulnerable, right? And it can sound very trite or said or redundant very easily. So it's really a vulnerable song for me, and love is a vulnerable topic. Yeah, that was one of my favorite music videos to shoot ever. We just were having fun the whole time. The idea for the music video was just born from me and my wife. I woke up one morning and she had this idea of a couple going to an Imagine Dragons show and the wife being a big fan and the husband not liking the band and being kind of a hater. And just kind of what that would look like. And as we talked about it, we formulated the idea more and more. And then we reached out to our favorite director who we'd worked with before, Matt Easton, and he helped kind of put the whole thing together. And when we were talking about who would be our dream couple to be in it, I love Always Sunny in Philadelphia. So I thought, well, I knew Rob and Caitlin were actually married in real life and thought, well, that'd be fantastic. And we reached out and they happened to be fans of the band. And so it just kind of came together. Yeah. I would definitely support my wife and be there. You know, for me, I find a lot of joy in seeing people I love be happy. Maybe it's not a show that I would want to be, but if she was happy there, then yeah, I hope that I would be, you know, I would be happy enough to stay and wouldn't leave. I would not leave. I would never leave her at that. Yeah. Really, Rick Rubin, our producer on the record, was very hands-on on that song. He pushed me to uncomfortable places. I had already written that demo before we got into the studio, but it was like 75% as aggressive and angry. It was a very angry song that I wrote in a state of really, like, it's a very manic song. But I didn't push it as far as it could have gone, and Rick pushed me to go there. And I'm glad we did. It's our fifth record, you know, so we really wanted to go to places that we have never gone before. And Rick Rubin, our producer, really got us there. I would say to expect the unexpected. You know, we really went places that we've never gone before. Our fans have been, I feel like we have the best fans in the world as far as their patience with us. We try different things always. We've never sounded like one thing. We've gone to a lot of different places, and then Follow You is kind of like the Beach Boys, and it's harmonic. And our fans have followed us through all of that, and that's really rad. Yeah, I would say volatile, emotional, celebratory. I love Billy. I think Phineas are geniuses together. Their music is fantastic. I love everything Billy does. I love Beyonce. I think Beyonce would be amazing to work with. She's an incredible artist. I think her visual art as well as her sonic ability and her voice is incredible. She's hard to beat. Peace and love to all of you. Thank you for supporting us for so many years, and we can't wait to get on the road again and come and see you. And we absolutely will be coming to China. It's an important territory to us, and it'll be soon. And I can't tell you the dates yet because my manager would kill me. But we look forward to seeing you soon. Yeah. Hi, fans from Q Music. This is Dan from Imagine Dragons. Want to know more about our music? Stay tuned to yuezhine.pi. See you.